MyPillow CEO Mike Lindell claims that as part of the lawsuit that he has filed, you know, to get his cell phone back from the FBI, he said earlier this past week that he and his legal team, which actually includes Alan Dershowitz, they have subpoenaed Obama's former CIA director because, dang it, I guess he is somehow involved in the confiscation of Mike Lindell's cell phone. So here is what he had to say. We also yesterday, now I'm going to get this wrong for sure, we subpoenaed Brennan Clapper, a guy named Baker, who were, by the way, Barack Obama's CIA director, director of national intelligence, and FBI general counsel. We subpoenaed them in this case. There were other names too, but I don't want to get them wrong in case they didn't get subpoenaed. Oh, we've got other people, but I don't want to name them in case we didn't actually do the thing I'm telling you that we totally did. It turns out, though, that they didn't do any of that. Like, even those Obama officials who've been out of office since January of 2017, so 5.5 years, these men that Mike Lindell thinks are somehow involved in the confiscation of his cell phone, out of office 5.5 years, but they didn't even actually get subpoenaed either. Reporters at Above the Law reached out to the court, you know, the judge in the case, like, hey, did these guys actually get subpoenaed? You know, we're just doing a records request. We would like to see the subpoena. And they came back like, no, that's no, we didn't subpoena these people. First of all, the court says that's not even how it would work. In order to issue any subpoena at all, what they would have to do is, you know, make their filing, and then we would determine whether or not we needed to, and then we would send a subpoena, not to the individuals, they would actually have to subpoena the Department of Justice in order to even start that process. But no, none of those subpoenas have even been issued. So nobody has any idea what the hell Mike Lindell is talking about. But more importantly, like, I don't care that they didn't actually issue the subpoenas. I want to know. I want to personally ask Mike Lindell this question. Why are you subpoenaing the Obama people, right? The people that have been out of office for 5.5 years by the time your cell phone was confiscated. How were they involved? Like, that's the part of this crazy conspiracy theory I would love to hear. Because we know it's all not true, right? Brennan, Clapper, Baker, they didn't have anything to do with Mike Lindell getting his cell phone confiscated. But man, wouldn't you love to hear the story? Like, whatever he's got cooking in his little brain, I would love to just hear him explain that. Like, all right, well, here's what happened. And it would just be a wild ride from start to finish. And it would be completely fabricated, possibly on the spot, by Mike Lindell. But we're never going to hear the story. He's probably already moved on. He's probably already forgotten that he even said those things. But no subpoenas have been issued. Obama's people that have been out of office for 5.5 years didn't play a role in any of this. You threw your lot in with somebody named Tina Peters. She got busted. She's facing all of these charges. You were right there with her every step of the way. And now you yourself might end up with some criminal charges against you if, of course, the Department of Justice finds the things they think they're going to find on that cell phone that you are so desperately trying to get back. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.